Hey guys, your boy Kirkpants, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Westerlo-Karamo, where last time left off, I picked up a win in the league, and I polished off my semi-final in the Cup. Now, you're probably looking at the screen saying, this isn't the Cup game, this isn't the final. I did say I was going to simulate a few games. Then I realized that it looks like I will have 10 games to play in the playoffs. Now, if it looks like that is the case, which would mean, including the cup final, that would be 11 games. If I did that, it would be uneven. But this way, this is the last game of the league season. This is the last league game. Yes, it means absolutely nothing, but this way, that's 12 games left, and that means there's 6 episodes remaining. Simple as you like. I mean, can't make it any more simpler than that. That's just simple math. I mean,
big welcome to
me. It made no sense to leave with 11.
The biggest welcome from me is to Alan Smith alongside me.
The cup final is in between
the match today.
This match against Vardaga, the start of the playoffs.
So this is how the hosts line up today. The shot's on.
Full extension,
the goalkeeper makes the save.
Now first versus third, a chance for that third place team, Martin, to
put them in front. What a fine save. He has cleared it well.
This way,
now a throw-in.
I'm not sure him.
Interesting to see what footwear the teams are going to use today, now that this rain is coming down. Might have to change what they originally started with.
And here's the shot. Well, he's had a go.
Well, if you don't buy a ticket, as they say, and fair play to him for having a crack.
This episode will be a full episode and not just a cup final one. I mean, I could have made this video just a cup final and, you know,
he's the one we're focusing on, I think with good reason.
Really has weighed in with quite a few goals in this competition.
He didn't reach 50 goals. He didn't score any more goals at all in the, games that you guys didn't
attacking power score. In this situation.
Despite the fact that I won all but one of them, I lost 1-0 in a synth game to Anderlecht to an 88th minute goal. I was fucking seeing red. I could not believe that happened. Quit past me. I'm just. Anderlecht will be in the playoffs, which means I'm gonna have 2 more games with them anyway. So I'm gonna get them back. Don't even worry. Don't even worry.
Yeah, I thought he might have done better there. Had a bit of time and space. Good position.
That's a bit annoying, but it was bound to happen sooner or later. I did expect to drop points, simming all the games. Luckily, I only lost one game, and it was only by the one goal. So, I think
Luca Maroni,
the team deserves fair play.
Short passes, but they're keeping the ball.
Doing so well.
Well, that's always the goalkeeper's ball, and a simple catch as much as anything is simple in this game.
So yeah, Gamvola didn't score any more goals, so he's still on 45 goals. I mean, he could still reach 50. I don't know if the playoffs are going to continue his count as a separate thing, or if they're going to continue on using
Highland.
Gamvola was the scorer in the playoffs with the.
He's coming forward.
Putting down as having 46 goals. Does it count as a league goal? Or does
it
count as a different thing? You know? I don't know. it's like a competition within a competition. I don't think there's going to be any celebrations after this game because, well, I haven't won anything yet. Because reasons.
And the tackler has been very successful there. He's got possession. Oh, chance! It's a goal and they're in front.
Great goal from Henry. Someone pointed out some very odd to me. Gamvola is an Antwerp player. I was confused by what this person was saying. They came to me on Twitter and said, hey, Gamvola is an Antwerp player. He's only on loan. He was bought and then he was loaned back to Westerlo for the remainder of the season. I was like, okay. So I looked it up. Sure enough, he is. He's on loan from Antwerp.
The scoring 1-0 here.
The fee wasn't listed. It's on his Wikipedia page. But what also caught my eye is who he was bought instead of. Because Anderlecht's initial target was Henry.
And the cross coming in.
I thought I was hallucinating when I saw that. I was like, wait. What? So they couldn't agree a fee with Henry's club for him, even though I bought him for 4.5 million. So obviously Anderlecht just didn't try hard enough.
And now the shot.
They signed Gamvola instead. That's a long way of doing it. I couldn't believe it. I was like, are Anderlecht watching me or something?
It's a great spell for this team.
Let's sign now. We can't agree with you for it. I'll just sign Gamvola then.
Restarting at 2.
That is. I refuse to accept that as just a crazy coincidence. You know? I refuse to accept
Luca Marone.
It's just a crazy coincidence. Now maybe it is. Or maybe it's not. I don't know, but that would be unbelievable.
And here comes the counterattack.
I'd like to think that someone at Anderlecht sat down, saw this on YouTube, he said, oh, what's this? It's Westbrook out there or not? Hurrah.
Chooses to punch here, the goalkeeper. Good technique. Good block. And the fourth official has held up
and
the
he's
ball to say 4 more minutes.
Performing well. Now, they could have gotten the idea from just real life or from a different career mode. I mean, there must be other Belgian career modes out there. But the fact that it's these specific two players, Henry and
the second half for you,
Gamvola, and I happen to be using both of them in the same team, and freaking, I hope Anderlecht won't be expecting 40 plus goals from Gamvola. I don't know if he's really capable of that. It could be just
a lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they still got the ball.
Although
they cope with it well defensively.
I'll be wary of any phone calls. If I get any phone calls from both, I'll let you guys know.
Oh, well saved.
That is a crazy, crazy
heading chance now. He's hit the frame of the goal and shoots.
It's hard to call it a coincidence because the more I think about it, the more I think. Hang on a second. There is no way that happens. If it is, it is a completely insane coincidence. That just happens to be the same two players.
Time for the goal kick.
I mean, Anderlecht could probably get both. I don't know why they weren't able to sign Henry. I mean, 4.5 million is all I got for. Now, maybe Henry's club in real life are probably
onto the attack
more.
Now. Rushing Anderlecht it here. Moving from one side to the other. Free kick given by the referee.
Maybe we can get a better deal or something.
They might regret conceding this.
There must be some good reason that they haven't.
It's a yellow card, and well, it was a certain yellow card, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Why back on it? He had
just off target from the free kick.
Well, it looked quite spectacular, but
that's a really good free. It's always comfortable. 5 million for Ravdi. A young, quick kick. Winger who's good on the ball.
Saw it all the way, the goalkeeper, and it's comfortable in the end.
I mean, give him the right tools, Henry can make something. I'm fully confident.
Regroup now.
Give him the right tools, give him the right stage.
Well, this guy looks like he's the one the opposition having the most problems with.
Oh, he's looked really lively today, hasn't he? He's been getting the ball in good areas.
He could be a star.
Shooting with both feet, and he's got himself a goal.
There's no worry about it. You know, is he good enough? Definitely. And Anderlecht must see something in both players as well. Otherwise, this wouldn't be the case. Now, they probably, if they have,
he's coming forward. With some danger.
I obviously saw something in real life with both players that, you know, rang a bell saying, you know what, these players are good.
Some players limbering up.
Get them through and turn them into superstars.
Cleared the ball. Goes for it with a fist. Here's the shot. That's a good save. He got a touch to that. Here's a chance. Well, could be a booking here.
Ah, really? Go away, referee.
And the decision is yellow.
I don't think anybody, least of all the...
Your man falls on me, and that's a yellow card for me.
Time ticking on.
Mm-hmm. Perfectly logical sense.
15 minutes to go. Attacking now. He might be through. He's got his shot off now.
3-0. That should be game over. The perfect end to the league season.
Really good. They pick the right pass every time now.
Well, to the league part.
Not there when needed. The goalkeeper, as it turned out.
No, one or two of his defenders looking at him, having words.
We'll see. We'll
decision from him.
Kick off the playoffs.
It's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
Yeah,
we've got 10 minutes left on the clock. Well, when they do,
I definitely think,
and you've been in these matches about the psychology of getting it right on the big day, you would have thought ability.
I want them to just treat
shots on here. It is a miss, a narrow miss.
I definitely.
Otherwise, we'd have been talking about one of the goals of the season.
Yeah, well, maybe this is the bias
on the breakaway. All it needed was a composed head at the end.
These players, and, you know, I've seen what I can do with them. I haven't seen these guys in real life, so I don't know if they're any good.
Clearly,
but if Anderlecht won,
quite clear who's.
Anderlecht must think these two players have something that. It's worth investing.
A timely challenge.
You know, don't sign a player if you don't think he's going to
routine for the keeper.
Improve you in some way. Unless you're Brendan Rodgers signing Christian Benteke.
And the decision for the added time.
You got rid of Andy Carroll. Cool. For specific reason that you don't play.
Very brave goalkeeping coming out like
balls.
This.
Up to the big four.
Had a lovely turn
so to get rid of Andy Carroll and bring in another big four who you have to play balls up to.
The referee's given it.
Suit his style. So, yeah, and last time I checked, Brendan Rodgers is the manager of Celtic and not.
Comprehensive win by 3-0 to nil. That's the final whistle.
Well, I think Anderlecht will be.
Enjoyed working with you.
Cable.
Yeah, it's been another really enjoyable season.
Giving,
do you know what? I can't wait.
Gamble and Henry, if they sign him, they'll probably go back for him in the summer.
Undoubtedly, he was the star man today.
Yeah. Especially if Henry was their first choice Now, maybe they didn't have... Now, maybe their board only gave their current real-life manager so much to work with, and with what they what he was given, he could only sign one. Maybe that's the case. I don't know. But regardless, I think he definitely, these players definitely will have bright futures, and especially if they are molded in the right way, you know? I hope I'm making sense. Why did I get 8.5 million for the end of the season, even though there's still more to go? Namely, yeah, all that. Anyway, that aside, yes, I'm using the second team for this because, well, one man here deserves all the praise. I mean, he's the sole reason that we're here right now. And he's gonna be rewarded fully. Yep. Nikolić is not only gonna get the glory that his performances throughout this competition have deserved, he is gonna take center stage when we lift the trophy in victory. Now, of course, we have to beat this team first, which shouldn't be any problem whatsoever. So far, this... in each game I've played, Nikolić has just fucking bossed it.
So often when you get to a final, one team is deemed to be stronger than the other. But for this one, it's hard to pick a winner, Alan.
It is when you look at the two sets of players. What will probably separate them is who can settle better.
For silverware of the football season.
There's some potential in this move. This is the starting lineup today.
That's kind of only half playing.
To be strong and solid, but they've got a bit of protection.
To be honest with you guys,
they should have more than enough. I mean, they're all good defenders in their own rights, but in front of them, they've got players who are going to be working really hard. Whether they could be a
final game of the league part of the season.
It's a big call as we look back on it, because
but, for this, this fully stayed
down. Yeah, I think that's why maybe he went just a little bit too early. He knew he was through, the lad. But
we don't need to see all the cards.
Give me the chance to get the
pocket. Just a free kick.
Double up in here.
Good reading of the play by the defender. This game really is a chance for him to express himself.
Two in his previous match. A clear danger man for the opposition.
Trying to find an opening.
Roman.
Not panicking.
Across the box. Oh, it's an own goal! A bad start from my opponent. A great start for me in the 13th minute. Very unlucky for that defender.
It's definitely an own goal.
It is. You'd like to try and defend him, but he just didn't make up his mind quickly enough there.
To obviously try and stop the ball reaching Nikolić. And my man over here on the wing, who it was coming to, but Adam
You're behind in a match when you've contributed.
However you say his name.
Position scoring with the own goal.
Was not very helpful. Such is the curse of a defender. Challenges with the ball. To an own goal. With this attack. And put his own team behind.
To keep the ball. That's a great
not very helpful. I think it was Mias who was the player who was actually going to.
Oh, he's beaten his marker.
Normally I would say it was a Romans, but he was the one crossing the ball in, so it couldn't be.
Knocked it away. Great piece
set
of defending.
Set to receive the ball. I know it wasn't the...
He's coming forward with some danger.
And the arm there, plus you can see the right leg. People like was standing in the box.
Got the tackle in.
The ball passed him.
And there's so, the interception.
The third different score onto the
Here's a chance! Somehow he saved it.
It's the players who scored in this competition.
You see the deflection there, corner.
Although no one is gonna catch Nico. He's definitely gonna be the top goal scorer because he's miles ahead of anybody.
Goes for goal with the header.
He'll give us one final cup performance.
He's normally a better header of the ball than that. Slightly mistimed.
I mean, we're already on track to win the competition with the opening goal.
Yassine El Ghanassi.
I had to win games, but I get a personal little bit of satisfaction when it's a player who I have
a equaliser. Well, they needed that, didn't they?
I won't win this game. Not like their chins will drop in there for a second. Because they've equalised.
Well, it has really game on in this match.
Terrible defending.
Equaliser.
Couldn't.
Both sides have scored here now.
This might sound like an excuse, but I really could not select the right player.
Tackle goes in.
I promise, that's not an excuse. I really couldn't. I was pressing it like as much as I could, but it kept switching me to the wrong player. Believe me or not, I don't care.
Yassine El Ghanassi.
That's my story, and if you don't like it, if you think I'm complaining, then
he's
that's
got
your
his tackle opinion. In, and the ball's gone out now.
But you're obviously.
I guess
not
he was aiming for a teammate, but he certainly didn't find one.
Take a look. Can he make it? 2-1, yes he can.
Let's put a marker down, and a marker down with a fat.
He scored every round. And this game was not level for very long as Nikolic scores his.
Well, it got
sixth.
A bit of help from the inside of the post, but in it goes.
Well, that can be truly described as unstoppable.
In off the post, but you know, they all count. Boom. Yep, 16 goals.
Restart the game, 2-1.
Ustian were only level for about 7 minutes. So they scored by Nico.
Stopping the pass getting through with good piece of
back on track.
Good strong tackle. Keeper's ball. And the added time will amount to 3 minutes at least. Patience is the name of the game at the moment. Into the attacking third. Good play. Half time now.
Half time. 45 minutes left in this competition. Unless there is another goal in this cup. Unless there is another goal in this final.
And this is the start of the second half.
This game screwed me over already once in this game. I wouldn't put it past the 8 to do it again.
working hard just to see maybe a sight of goal.
Great tackle by Heyman.
Try and get the ball back now. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Romans. Back to Nikolic. Oh! Toe.
As tightly as they can. This corner
did enough to deny. 3-1. Off his kneecap. Now for the corner.
And now the shot!
Romans. Cleared away. It's gonna go straight to my goalkeeper though. And, yes.
Well, they're in a good position here.
Yes.
He needed to time that
corner.
To corner. Could have been worse if he got it wrong.
Challenge.
Well, there's going to be an alteration now, and with the team trailing, you can understand why he's going to make it.
Great header down by Nico. Roman attempt is saved by Proto. It's another corner.
Corner goes straight to the opposition.
In combination again.
Good work by the goalkeeper.
Same result. No corner. Caught this time, saved and put out for a corner, which is the only difference. With the two corners that just occurred there.
Probing away, trying to find room for a shot, maybe.
Come on, how did you not get that ball? I was pressing the button to tackle, and you just completely missed the ball with the tackle. Was the boy pressing the button then? Huh? Can you explain that to me? I'm waiting.
Really on top of that.
I don't give a shit.
He might be through.
This game can't hear.
Right.
Yeah, 3-1 Nikolic again.
By two now. They'll feel a little bit more comfortable.
He's
good value.
He's
for this advantage.
Soaking it all in. He's drinking it in.
Not there when needed.
He is fucking loving
it. No, one or two of these defenders looking at him. Having
nice little
thing. Poor decision.
That's what. We like to see.
Three won the scoreline as we restart the game.
3-1. That gives me a nice 2-goal gap. And now,
Christian
will have to score 2 goals to have a chance to save this team. Extra time!
Full extension, the goalkeeper makes
well, I'm looking for a 4th and probably killing goal.
Corner.
Yes!
Stop by the goalkeeper. Time ticking on, just over 15 minutes to go. That's cut out. Attacking well here. No time to panic, there's still time.
Hey.
The manager on the sidelines waving his
hand. I don't know what they were supposed to be trying there.
Pool.
Fell miserably. So, good work.
And they've cut it out. And the manager's
preventing
make
that going
here.
Out for the throw.
7 more minutes to go.
Oh, they're giving the ball away! Oh, I thought I could catch the Prot. They're the keeper Pro out by surprise with the shot. Yeah, didn't happen. Kawata! The defender! Saved the keeper's ass.
That's what we've had so far.
That's there was that would be 4-1. Although it's all but over now. Coming down the crunch well. Time.
Into a quite a dangerous position now. Good play, but they've lost the ball now, and the opposition could get at them. Jurgensen.
There's the full-time whistle. The cup is won.
We've been knowing for some time that they
a break from Nikolic and the own goal
Alan,
will make the Ustyango goal irrelevant.
They've worked long and hard.
And the players can enjoy themselves, and I will let them in the players.
These are special moments.
And I will let you all enjoy the celebration. Team.
Congratulations.
Thanks for watching. Enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. In the next couple of episodes, you will see
wonderful
the playoff games.
Here.
Until then,
and
I hope you all
moment.
Have a very
want nice to make day. Absolutely the most of this.
Well, they're a proper team, aren't they? They've stuck together, defended really well in this competition, and snatched the goals at the vital time. So, fully deserved winners.
There they go. They are the champions. Great moments these, Alan, sharing the joy on the field with those off it, the fans. They'll know where their particular friends and families are in the stadium.
Yeah, it's at this point really you don't want to leave the pitch. You don't want these moments to end. Wonderful camaraderie between the lads. What a moment for them.
Well, you have to have the team photo. Getting ready for it now.
Yeah, one of those lovely scenes that you'll hang on the wall back at home.